So it might surprise some of you to know that in my top five list of operatic composers of the 18th century, I would unhesitatingly include, amongst Vivaldi and Handel, a composer called Johann Adolf Hasse. When you do a bit of research, you realise that Hasse was probably the most famous composer of the 18th century, funnily enough. He was like the international opera star of that period. And in fact, him and his wife, Faustina Bordoni, who was a soprano, they were kind of like the 18th century power couple in opera. Hasse was German-born, but he travelled to Italy, studied how to make opera, and he was also a tenor himself. Married Faustina, and then made this extraordinary international career in opera. And his operas were the mainstay of court and public theatre for about 30 years. He's known to opera historians mainly because of his contacts with two very important people. The first one is Farinelli. He considered Farinelli to be almost like his brother. So together you had the greatest singer of the 18th century, the greatest opera composer, and the third person that was part of this little triangle was Pietro Metastasio, who was probably the greatest librettist. He's the person who writes the stories that composers set. And this little triangle, they were very close. And if anyone's interested, we have an extraordinary picture in the National Gallery of Victoria of Farinelli and Metastasio, and you can see this here in Australia. It's an amazing picture that just happens to be here in Australia. Now, I came to know Hasse's work in great detail, actually. Around 1999 was the 300th year of the anniversary of his birth. He was born in 1699. And that was just around the time when Vivica was also coming onto the scene. And there was a whole spate of recordings around this great man, operas, oratorios, and it was quite extraordinary. It was like a treasure trove of this composer. It suddenly just came out of nowhere. Hasse is very interesting. If you know Handel or Vivaldi, then his style will be familiar to you. But at the same time, he's quite different. He inhabits a slightly different world. He's kissing the border with what we might call classical music. And so some of his later music sounds a little to us like young Mozart or Haydn. So in fact, he sort of is a bit of a transitional period, but that doesn't do him justice because he's a phenomenal dramatic composer. And I think that he's one of the best composers to write for the human voice. And I know that because I've conducted some of his works. And what's extraordinary is he really, as a tenor himself, he understands the voice. And so he frames it in this most extraordinary way of the orchestra, constantly supporting it, highlighting it when the voice is low, making sure it can be heard, but also supporting it in its full flight. I would say Handel, Schubert and Hasse write the best for the voice. Hasse has been on the main stage of European opera houses for about 20 years. And I think it's really, the time is ripe now in Australia for Australian audiences to hear the work of this extraordinary composer.